how are the preparations ahead of this encounter?
Yeah, you said it's going to be really tough as always, but especially because of the form they have. In my opinion, right now the best team in terms of results, not conceding goals, scoring an average of 2 goals per game, winning, of course, all the games they are playing lately, both in PSL and in Nedbank Cup. A team that has changed from the beginning of the season, a team that is playing much more direct. Also, I think with the new signings, they are improving. I think Evan Ga is giving them a lot in terms of goals, but in terms of the approach they want to have when playing counter-attacks or playing direct and from there, getting the second balls and go for quick and vertical attacks, and it's working for them. And at the same time, a team which is better work also defensively, much more solid, much more compact, with hard-working players, but players who can understand as well the game and what the situation requires every single moment. So it's going to be really tough, and from that side, the most important thing is that we need to understand in this preparation that we are going to face those difficulties. You know, we are a kind of team that when we have to face the big teams, the most complicated games, we are always switch on, and from there we are performing really well, we are competing, we are offering good shows. Sometimes we are getting the results, sometimes we are not getting the results, sometimes even when we deserve, we have some other problems there. But the real thing is that when we are playing this kind of games and we listen the name of the next opponent and we are not that motivated, we complicate ourselves that much in the game. So for me, this is the most important thing in terms of preparation. Of course, we are trying to prepare the game tactically and to continue with the things that we are doing lately, adjusting the situations as always. We need to explode to take advantage of their weaknesses and to minimize their strengths. But the most important thing, as I already said, is the way we are approaching mentally this game, and in terms of keep fighting for the objectives to finish in the log in the highest position as possible. We need to think that this is a final and it's a crucial game for us.
Coach.
Sorry. Ladies first.
Coach, despite your despite the loss in your last game in the DStv Premiership, you said that Amazon really put up a good fight. Just how important is it to keep that momentum going into the next remaining games?
No, it was not only a matter of a good fight, it was a matter of quality, about how well we played when we were 11 against 11, even with one man down, how we dominated one of the best teams in the continent in the backyard. The opportunities we had to score, not only the red card, there's a penalty to Mulenga in the last minutes of the first half. The goal they are scoring is coming from a situation where there's a clear fault to Brooks and he's laying down, so they are scoring against 9, so that means that in 3 games Orlando Pirates in positional attacks were not capable of scoring us a single goal. As many times during the season, the goal scoring chances, which some of them were very clear, went to the post or the goalkeeper trying to save them, so we didn't have that accuracy. But proud for the also behavior of the team, the fight they deliver, and also the quality and the display they gave. I think we saw a great show from our side, and of course it's important to keep that momentum. I think this is coming not only from the last game. I think in Nedbank we played an amazing game here, amazing for the fans, also decided by some other situations. We came from Cape Town, one of the most dominant teams in this competition. Weather conditions were tough and we were capable of beating them away, so the moment of the team is there, and we want to keep going and to keep pushing. We know it's a difficult moment, we know we are all really tired after 10 months being here. It's the last effort, it's the last month. Tough schedule, you know, 6 games in 4 weeks, it's not going to be easy, but I think we have that ambition of finishing in a place that we really deserve and that so far we are not reaching.
Coach,
Coach, you mentioned that you were happy with how the fight that your team showed in the last two games against Pirates. So would you say it was easier for you now to move on from that going into the Chipper game, or you still feel like the boys had a tough time recovering from it?
I said, first of all, that I'm happy with the fight, with the display, with the way we play, with the many good things we did and we showed everyone in these games, you know. I think we were playing, as I said, one of the best teams in not only this league but the continent, and I think we played really good football, and I think this is something that everyone saw and everyone said, from the media, from the fans, no matter if they were supporting Pirates or they were supporting us. And I don't know, what I can tell you is that for us, what is difficult is what I mentioned already in the first question. That is that mentality and that approach to the games when it comes to the biggest teams in the competition, or it comes to the teams which are the real, our real competitors, you know. And we are, or these players are much motivated, when they are facing these kind of teams like Pirates. And for me, this is the main concern, because I know that when we are motivated, we are a really tough team to beat, and we are playing good games and we are offering good shows to everyone. And that's the main concern. If we understand that, then I'm sure that we are going to play good football and we are going to have our chances to win the game. If we don't understand that properly, and we are not respecting the way we shoot the opponent, and we enter into the game in a slow pace, then is when we are going to have trouble, because they are a team right now, which I said already, are very solid, and they punish you without doing many things. So against this kind of teams, or you are switch on the 90 minutes plus the injured time and you are doing your best, or then you can be in trouble, you can see a goal in one situation where you are not focused 100% or organized properly, and from there you need to chase the game and it's going to be complicated.
Coach, you already spoken about the fact that it's the last month of the season and most teams are already using this time to prepare for next season as well. Have you started to prepare for a new season, just to identify which position that you need to beef up ahead of the new season?
And we are preparing the team to be competitive till the end, and at the same time we are trying to accelerate a little bit the process for next season in terms of playing style or the things that we wanted to evolve and we didn't see us to be ready to do before. From there, on the pitch, the process is in motion and we are trying to speed it up. And off the pitch, I think we start having conversations. And of course, from there, the important thing is not only what you talk and the ideas you have, but to finalize those ideas, you know, because otherwise we go back to the same situation as 3 months ago, and there were good ideas on the table and possibilities, and finally we couldn't get them. And I think for next season, if we really want to keep going and improving, we need that extra quality, especially up front. This is something that everybody knows, you know. We were lack of goals and accuracy this season in many games, and I think this is something that we need to solve for next season. We are improving, the players we have from the very beginning have improved a lot, their figures in terms of goals scored are much better than in the previous season, seasons, so that means that the improvement is there, and they are now better players and they have capacity to score more goals. In the case they all continue, of course we are going to be very happy with them and we will try to keep improving them, but also when you are getting someone who already proves that he can reach those figures, it's going to facilitate the process and it's going to get us closer to the results we want to have.
Hey coach, besides Mubara who's suspended, are there any injury concerns or maybe fatigue concerns after very physical games that you've played?
No, the only one who is injured is Mayola. You know, he's training for us, for a long time, and he's not making his debut yet with the first team, but he's involved in the normal schedule of the first team. He's the only one out. The other ones, the one who were injured, are training with the team, and we'll wait until tomorrow to see if they are going to be available and be part of the 20 list. And Mobara right now is suspended because we sent a report to PSL, because when you are receiving a red card for first of all, probably it's not even a red card due to the situation, but especially it's because it's not even a foul. And then when someone else is making a mistake, if you need to be punished for the mistake of someone else, I think it's something ridiculous, you know. We are not talking even about being fair, it's about something that it's crazy. So the report is there in PSL. We are waiting for 2 days to the reply, because we are expecting Mobara to be available for this game and for the upcoming games, because not counting for 3 games on a key player for something that he didn't do and it's already proof, you know, I think would be something again bad for this football and for this competition.
Coach, we're drawing ever closer to the penultimate stages of the season. From the perspective of the head of the technical team, how much improvement have you seen from this team ever since you first touched ground on these fields?
Huge improvement. We still have a long way to go, and we have a lot of margin to improve. But I remember when I arrived here the first time and we started playing pre-season and the first league games where we were not capable of shooting more than one or twice on target, till now where we are playing face to face against all the teams here, we are creating goal scoring chances. We try to build the team also in terms of being solid in defense, and I think now we are reliable, you know, and we understand much better some game situations. I think technically, in terms of the figures of every single player, in terms of where the players were coming from, many of them being residual players for this club last season, not playing too much, some others coming from MDC teams, you know, sending players to national team, which is not happening in the recent history for a club like us, I mean infield players, not only Veli, you know. So there are many things in terms of the improvement and also in terms of the results we are getting. 12 years without reaching a quarter final in Nedbank Cup, could have been a semi-final if we don't have those other factors. We reach semi-final in Carlin, without those other factors maybe we could have reached the final. In the league, it's true that we are down in the log, not where we wanted to be, but also there are some other factors affecting that. But I think we are playing good football and we are fighting for all the games. So from there, I think the improvement is there. In KwaZulu-Natal, this team came from situations of not winning a single derby during the season or not being better than the direct opponents, and this season I think we are dominating these teams, Arrows, Richards Bay, Royal, AM, so improvements and good results are there, and facts, you know, that we would like to be better, that we think that we deserve to be in a much better position according to what we are showing. Yes, but this is football, this is a game, there are some other factors that we cannot control and which are affecting. From there, we need to be resilient, to keep working, to keep pushing, and to continue doing our best, because this is the best thing of this team, that you are saying if there's been improvement from the very beginning of the season, I'm telling you that a huge one, but the important thing is that now we have the opportunity in the upcoming month to keep improving, you know. Many teams are stopping, many teams are not interested maybe any more in keep improving, in keep performing. They are thinking, as some of your colleagues said, in the next season. For us, we need to think of next season, but we need to think of the next training tomorrow to be a little bit better, and then we are going to be closer to the results we want first on Saturday, then on Tuesday, then the next week when we go and play Stellenbosch.
Thanks, coach.
Thank you, coach.